In this video, we will talk about what is the difference between string and string builder. Now, before even I go ahead and I talk about string and string builder, let me make one big statement here about strings. Strings are immutable. So what we'll do is, let's first try to understand this statement. What exactly does it mean when we say that strings are immutable? Now, what happens is, when you go and declare a variable like string here, let's say string x is equal to Shiv, okay, and let's say I have one more statement after this saying x is equal to Raju, okay. Now, you know, when you go and run your application, right, what happens is, now let's say your application is running, you can see on the screen, and the application is now going to go and execute this line of code, string x is equal to Shiv. So when this line is executed, internally what happens is, a memory area for x is created. For x, there is a memory allocation done, and the value Shiv is stored in that x area. Now, when the second line of code is executed, that is when you set this x variable to Raju, you know, you must be concluding that, okay, that means, you know, wherever the x variable was stored, in that memory now, you know, Shiv should be removed and Raju should be, you know, pushed over there, right? But that doesn't happen internally. What happens is, the previous memory allocation done to x is not changed at all. It is just left as it is. And a new memory allocation for the x is done internally, and over there Raju is shifted. In other words, you know, at this line of code, right, we have two memories allocated separately to x. One which stores the old value Shiv, and the other one which stores the new value Raju. So in other words, the string variable x is immutable. Immutable means the value will not change. So rather than changing the original value, what it is doing is, it is going and creating new copies of data and storing the current value in the new copies. Now, I'm not sure that if you are believing me or not, because it's very strange, right? You know, because even when I heard this first time, you know, I was not ready to believe it. I said that you set x is equal to Shiv, and after that you said that x is equal to Raju. That means the previous copy will be modified, right? So in order to understand this, what we'll do is, let's do a very nice practical demo here to see that, does this x gets allocated multiple times, or is it the same what you call memory storage that is getting updated, right? So what we'll do is, let's quickly go and write a big for loop here, and in that for loop we will do some heavy concatenation. So what I'll do is, let me go and define x variable here, a string variable, and let me go and run a big for loop. So I equal to 0, go until, let's keep a big number, and I plus plus, and in this what we'll do is, we'll just go and in this x, right, we will set this to Shiv and plus x, right? So as per the discussion we had previously, now what should happen here is that 10,000 different memory copies of x variables should be created internally. So every time this for loop runs, a new x memory copy is created and the value is stored over there, right? Now, in order to justify our statement, or in order to prove our statement that this x variable will create multiple copies of the data, what we will do is, we'll go and take help of this nice tool here called as the CLR profiler tool. Now, the CLR profiler tool you can just get from the internet. If you just go and Google CLR profiler, the first link which will come to you is of Microsoft.com. So this tool actually comes from Microsoft. So you can go and download it from Microsoft.com itself, right? Now, what does this tool do? This tool will help us to find out that how much memory our application is using, or how much managed memory our application is using. Okay, so if you go and download this tool, you know, you'll find that there are two folders here. One is the 32-bit folder and the other one is the 64-bit folder. So depending on what kind of machine you have to choose one of them. So currently my machine is 32-bit. So I'm going to go and you know, choose this folder here, and I'll go and run the CLR profiler exe. Now you can see that you know, when the CLR profiler runs, you know, there's a small box which pops up and says that, okay, what do you want to profile? Do you want to profile calls as well as memory consumptions? This allocations are nothing but memory consumptions. So yes, we are interested currently in that. So I've gone ahead and I have checked this allocation checkbox. And after that, you have to go and give your exe path, you know, to the CLR profiler. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go quickly first, go and build this application, right? And now I'll go to the CLI profiler tool here, and I will go and give the path of the exe to this profiler tool. So I'm going to go and give this path over here, so you can see that that is my console application 3. Go and give this path. And now what it does is it actually goes and starts running your application, and you can see that he has popped up a nice summary report here. So first thing what we'll do is, you know, we'll go and copy this summary report, you know, just for reference sake. So I'm going to go and click on this edit here, and I've clicked on copy, and I'll just open a notepad and I'll go and save this report over here, okay, in the notepad, so that we can refer it later on. Right, now the first thing, if you notice here, if you just click on this objects by address, you can see that the string variable is consuming 96% of the total memory. So if 100% is the memory allocated to application, it is consuming like 96%, and you can see that what you call the garbage collector graph, right, or the type of objects of the garbage collector. You can see this gen 0 here, which is quite large, and also the system.string here saying that it is 96%. That is one thing. The second thing which is very interesting to see is the timeline. Now here you can see that if you see watch very closely here, you can see how this graph is exponentially getting incremented, and you can see the small spikes over here going up and down. Those are nothing but, you know, like objects are getting allocated and then they're getting garbage collectors. So getting allocated, they're getting garbage collectors. So you can see, like, the first thing very important to notice here, that it is rising exponentially. Okay, so in other words, it is actually not updating the same memory, but it is actually creating new memories. Okay, so this exponential rise over here, this one, you know, the top one, it is actually, it shows that that, you know, the objects are getting allocated freshly again and again. New memories are getting allocated to the objects, you know, when you set the variable to the X string. Okay, so let me just go and close this now. So what's the cure for this, or what's, you know, so how do we go and avoid this? Now before even I go and say that how we can go and avoid this, the first thing we would like to know is that why was this created? Why is this behavior in such a way that you know, when you go and assign this X variable, right, why is it creating new copies of the data? What's Microsoft thought process, you know, behind creating such kind of a design, or behind creating strings as immutable? What is that thought process? The immutable design was implemented in strings, you know, for only one reason, and that is thread safety. Think about, like, you have a string variable, and that string variable is manipulated by hundreds of threads. So you can have thread issues, right? You can have thread safety issues. But now, you know, because of this immutable design, what will happen is new memory copies will be created, you know, rather than going and updating the same one. And because new copies are created, every thread allocation which happens, you will get a fresh copy of data. So you will never run into this thread safety issues, at least for the string data type. Said and done that, if you think the other way now, if you say that, no, like, my application doesn't have any kind of multi-threading functionalities, so this is like overhead, right? Because creating new copies of data, you know, will definitely consume a lot of memory. And that's where, you know, we have the answer for it: string builder. So let's go and run this same example by using a string builder. So what I'll do is I'll quickly go and change this to string builder. Saying new string builder. And I'll just say here x dot append shift. Now because you are using a string builder, right, you know, this x dot append will not create new fresh memory locations. It will actually go and update the same memory location. So now if I go and build this, so let's go and build this, and let's go and run our CLR profiler again to see what kind of difference we have. So I'm going to go and run this, and I'll go and monitor everything. So here's my application. Let me browse it. Let me open it. Right. Now, the first thing is, let's look at the allocated bytes. You remember I had copy-pasted, you know, the allocated bytes in a notepad. So let me open that, the previous results. So there it is. You can see the allocated bytes here is 136597. And look at here. It's a huge number. Huge difference, right? First point. The second point is, look at the objects by address. Okay, you can see it's like approximately 60% here consumption. And let me just go back again to the results which we previously recorded. So you can see that this thing is 40023561, you know, which is very large as compared to 136597, right? So you know why this much memory has been consumed, you know, because it was allocating fresh copies of data, fresh copies of memory, right, for every concatenation, for every for loop, while he was going and appending the same memory location, right? So in other words, now the question comes is, okay, so when do we use the string and when do we use the string builder? You will use the string builder, you know, when you think that your string variable is going to change again and again and again. Like for example, this for loop here, you know, where we see there's a huge concatenation happening. For such kind of scenarios, definitely string builder is a good choice. You will use string, you know, when you think that your data is almost constant or it varies very less. Okay. So, you know, that was a very, in-depth explanation of string and string builder. So in other words, your string is immutable while string builders are mutable, or, you know, they can change. Okay. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. In this video, we were trying to understand, you know, what is the difference between string and string builder. Thank you so much.